स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई एम अनुजा पल्लाडे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज एनहांस ईआर मॉडल, इट्स कंपोनेंट्स एंड हाउ टू कन्वर्ट ईआर इनटू द आरडीबीएमएस टेबल्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. व्हाट इज ईआर मॉडल? एनहांस एंटिटी रिलेशनशिप मॉडल इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ईआर. Are basically expanded upon the version of ER diagrams. ER models are helpful tool for designing the database with high level models. With their enhanced feature, you can plan databases more thoroughly by delving into the properties and constraints with more precision. To see here in this video step by step, an ER diagram provides you with all the elements of an ER diagram while adding attribute relationship inheritances, how to manage them, then category upon the union types, then we have to see what is subclasses and superclasses, then we have to see what is specialization and what is generalization. Apart from this, we are going to see what is aggregation also. So designing both diagrams make designing your database easier than ever, that is generalization or specialization, as you need it a great diagramming tool to give the template shapes notations you need to create your EER or ER diagram in a flash. Let's start to understand how the EER works exactly with the help of example. Students, here I am taking one entity. You can see vehicle named entity I have taken here, and you know, for any entity attributes are there. So let's add some attribute for vehicle here. Their name will be type, number or owner. So these are the attribute for any vehicle, that any vehicle have the, his type, any vehicle has his unique number and unique owner also. Again I add some more attributes here, the name having truck, car or scooter. Suppose these three are the another three entities, or you can see here car is a vehicle, truck is a vehicle, scooter is also vehicle. These subclass and superclass concept we are looking here. So let's add their own attribute to them. Car is having suppose mileage, truck is having his capacity, and scooter is having stock. Means these are the own attribute of these scooter entity, or this is the own attribute of the truck. Means every vehicle has no capacity, so these are the individual capacity. So this is the super class, we can say, and from this super class we have extract disjoint truck entity or disjoint scooter entity or disjoint car entity. So you can say this is the super class and these are the sub class of vehicles. Now how to show the relationship between this superclass and subclass using the enhanced ER diagram? So you have to put here such circle, in that you have to put D means disjoints, and let's join them. So once we join them, as this is the super class and these are the subclasses, you have to put here some sign on these lines, then only it going to show that these are the subclasses or disjoint classes of this main super class. So let's put such subset symbol here on every line. So this is the special symbol to show the EER diagram. So this is main here, that you have to join this super class with these subclasses using such disjoint symbol with subset symbol too. Now let's start how to convert now these EER diagram into the table. As previously we have seen that in entity relationship diagram that we have seen that there are some step that how the composite key will become the different table and how the entity become the name of the table and all attributes become column of the table. Same concept as it is concept of the ER diagram we are going to use here for converting the ER diagram into the RDBMS table. But the different is here that whenever we are starting to develop this project in terms of DBMS means relational table, if we first draw this table and then we extract this disjoint table as a subsets of the main superclass, means top down approach if we are using, means first we design this table and then this table. It means we are using top down approach. Such approach for converting the EER into the table is called as specialization. Exactly opposite to this, when we first design these three different tables with their attributes and then we are to combining all of them to make the single table, means here we are using bottom up approach. First we are here drawing this table, developing these tables, and then from these three table we are combining and preparing this table. It means here we are using bottom up approach. Such kind of approach for converting EER into the table, RDBMS table, is known as generalization. So this is one another very important concept which is enhanced from the ER diagram, that how to convert the EER into the table. Let's understood EER with another example. Let's take another entity, that is celebrity. Now let's add some more entities here. Suppose I added actor and politician here. Now celebrity he is having his own attributes like celebrity name, celebrity address, likewise. So some unique attributes having actor too, without then celebrity. Celebrity with a cricketer, actor attribute is also with his. I am not drawing here. So actor is having his own attributes, how many movies done work, likewise. Politician, how much time he become a MLA. So likewise the attributes are here also. I am also not drawing these attributes. One thing I want to clear with all of you that there is another type to join them with the superclass. These are the subclasses and this is the superclass. Suppose when we are converting it into the table, that time we are going to join this using such concentric hole. This is the one circle and in that instead of D we have put this hole circle. This should be the concentric. Here is somewhat difference in a design, but you have to put here a hole. So why hole? Now you can see here vehicle is a superclass and these are the subclasses. Here you can see car never become a truck, truck never become a car, car never become a scooter, scooter never become a truck. Means these are disjoint from each other. What I am saying, these subclasses are disjoint from each other. That's why we put it here a D. And what about here? Why we put here whole? Because actor become a politician, politician become a actor. So instead of disjoint small d, we have to put here a whole, concentric whole, and let's join them with this such symbol which is the specialized in enhanced AR diagram. So this one is the another example that why in a previous diagram we put a D here, that is disjoint, because their subset are disjoint from each other. And here you can see actor become a politician and politician become an actor. These are not disjoint, that's why we put a hole here. So let's discuss about the aggregation here. Here you can see I have added already some entities here with the relationship in between them. Suppose this is the student entity, principal entity and college entity. You can see here one relationship in between the student and college, that student studies into the college whereas college studies the student. Here is one relationship. And these entities also having some relationship with these entity. What will be the relationship? That as this is the student principal, this is college principal also. Yes. Then instead of adding the similar relationship in between repetitively in two entities, we are trying to aggregate these entities in one entity. We are considering here two entities as a one entities. Now, as I previously told, what is the relationship in between principal and student? Like principal take efforts on student, even a principal takes effort on college also. Now instead of repeating this, as we aggregate these two entities into the entity, we can show the single relationship in between these aggregated entity with the principal entity. So this is nothing but the aggregation. I hope you understood the aggregation. So let's see now what is difference in ER and EER diagram. An ER diagram gives you the visual outlook of your database. Its detailed relationship and attributes of its entity paving the way for smooth database development in the step ahead. Whereas EER diagrams, on other hand, are perfect for taking more detailed look at your information. When your database contains a larger amount of data, it is best to turn an enhanced model to more deeply understand your model. I hope you must understood here in this video what is enhanced ER diagram and its all components, that is generalization, specialization, subclass, superclass, different approaches to convert the EER diagram into the relationship tables and difference also. Thank you for watching the video.